Hello, welcome to Cooking with David. Today we're going to make another dessert, and it's, what am I calling it? Baked suet pudding. And I'm going to be using strawberries, which I found in my freezer from last year. And I haven't got any raspberry jam or raspberry sauce, so I'm going to use raspberry. I haven't got any strawberry, so I'm going to use raspberry. And this is dated 18, so... Well, let's see if I can open it. Eh? Let's give it a helping hand off camera. Oh, yeah, there we go. And because this is what I've made, I'm obviously going to give it a couple of tests. The first one is the sniff test. Smells absolutely divine. And then the next one is the taste test. Wow. Now that's 2 years old, and that's just pure, where are we? Pure raspberry. Some sugar, a little bit of lemon juice, that's it. And that's dated July 18, so 18 months old. Now what I'm gonna do is, the liquid is too, I need to thicken up the liquid, so I'll drain the strawberries and put this raspberry on to boil, to bring it to the boil. And whilst it's doing that, we'll make the suet. Now I've got 8 ounces of flour, self-raising flour, just normal Atura suet. You can get the vegetarian options, or the vegan option these days as well. So you need 2 ounces, which is approximately a quarter of this packet. So a bit of that, that looks, yes, about right. Not a lot can go wrong. And that goes back in the freezer until I'm going to use it again. Couple of teaspoons of sugar. Now I don't want to put too much in because my filling, which is on the stove warming up, is going to be very sweet. So we'll give this a quick mix, and then all we're going to do is add some milk to bring it all together. Quickly roll it out and put it in this glass bowl. Now I'm going to bake it rather than steam it. One, because it takes quite a while to steam. And two, it's for my tea, my dessert this evening. So just add enough liquid to bring all the ingredients together to form a rollable dough. And as you can see, I've just put too much bloody liquid in. But it's not the end of the world. At all. Nothing can go wrong. So we'll just add a bit more flour. A little bit more, and then I'll start using my hands on that. Now you can use anything as a filling for this. You could just use the basic suet with a little bit more sugar, some dried fruit, mix it all together and bake it. Now I need to thicken this up, and what I'm going to use is corn flour. Now if you're ever adding, well, the rule is you never add powder to a hot liquid, because if I did that into there, this would cook instantly and there'd be lumps everywhere. So you have to put it in water. So it's now in liquid form. And I'm just going to add a tiny bit, a little bit, until I get to the consistency I'm kind of happy with. Because this is going to be served hot. So it needs to be a little bit thicker, because if it was cold, it would thicken even more. Okay, that's good. Right, do you see the thickness of that? And then what I'll do is I'll add the strawberries to that. So I have a raspberry and strawberry filling. Super. Yes, it might not be the best colour, because that's, yeah, but that's the price you pay for 100% organic, homegrown, home produced food. And cochineal red colouring comes from beetles. And I don't know about you, I don't want to eat beetles. Not because I care for the beetle. I just don't want to eat beetles. Right, so we'll grab this piece of dough, stickier than I wanted. But well, it's not too bad, we've picked it back up. So all I'm gonna do is literally roll it in a circle and stick it in my bowl and then fold the tops over afterwards. Keep it simple. It's the same, kiss. Keep it simple, stupid. Right. And I'm not bothered how thick it's gonna be, because that's the idea. So, that goes straight into there. And then what I'm going to do is throw the filling into the middle. And then whatever pastry we've got at the top, we'll just fold it straight over. Because the idea then is we'd take it out of the bowl, turn it over and serve it on a plate and cut it up that way. That's the aim anyway. And we shall see. So I'm now going to put the filling into the middle, like so. No airs and graces. And we literally just fold this over. Yeah, my pastry could have been a bit bigger, or maybe not have as much filling. But we don't care, do we? We don't mind. So this is obviously going to start to bubble out a little bit as it cooks in the oven. But that's okay. It's only for me. I haven't got to impress anyone. But what I will do, and I don't use tin foil very often, if ever. However, I need it today. So we'll give that a quick cover. And she goes in the oven. And I'll see you in a little while with the result. Okay, right, I've taken it out of the oven. And I've left it to rest for about 20 minutes. Okay, that's not looking too bad. But there was a split in it. You remember that, don't you? Now, if I'm lucky enough, and that it's not stuck, at all to the bowl, because what I'm going to do is to turn it upside down, or to turn it out of the bowl. Let's see if we can do it or not. Right, let's go for it. Okay. You ready? Come on. That's gonna piss me off now, isn't it? You bastard. Just one bloody bit. Oh well, never mind. But if I'd bothered to grease my bowl, then that wouldn't have happened, right? So, right. Now, as I said at the beginning, I probably put too much filling in. And as you can see, I put too much filling in. However, let's make a mess in my kitchen. Let's see if I can see what it looks like when we take a slice out. And I'll use the same equipment. Look at that. Look at that. Can you see that? What we needed, right, there's a good, four portions, maybe five. Big dollop of either fresh cream or custard. I'm going to have a taste of this. Look how soft that is. You know? Anyway. Wow. And it's still hot. Yep. Could do with some nice sweet vanilla custard. Anyway, hope you enjoy it just as much as I will in about 20 minutes' time. See you on the next one.